Good evening, everyone. I so wanted this game to be good. Really. Instead, it's a lot of wasted potential, with the good ideas buried below sloppy execution, bad balancing, and an incredibly monotone structure. But everything in order. Damascus Gear is developed by A-Plus Games and published by Arc System Works. Damascus Gear is originally a mobile phone game, available on Android and iOS, and has been rearranged for the PlayStation Vita as a downloadable title. Rearranged, as the Vita version of Damascus Gear is a completely different game than its smartphone counterpart, though it still shares the world, some graphical and musical assets, as well as the gears, the customizable robots you'll pilot throughout the various missions the game is composed of. Missions are divided in ranks, from E to S, and each rank has a certain number of missions that must be completed before undertaking an exam to advance in rank. All missions can be replayed to get a better evaluation, though there are no other benefits than that. Mission tasks are varied enough, from the usual destroy all enemies to races between waypoints, arena duels, and escort missions. Missions are set in two maps, either a roughly hexagonal arena, or what probably is a war-torn Tokyo. The latter is composed by several sub-maps, but terrain variety is very limited, with enemies spawning at the same locations in every mission, removing every bit of tension when exploring the same place a second time. Enemies are, of course, various types of gears, and they become more dangerous as the game progresses, though this is limited to their health points and the weapons they use. After the first missions, it's clear that the enemies are brain dead. They will stand while attacked, retreat under fire in a straight line, won't make any attempt to dodge any kind of attack, group together right into whatever ranged weapon you are firing, use the wrong weapons, or ignore you completely. This behavior is shared by all enemies, from the cannon fodder to bosses, and while bosses and mini-bosses offer a little bit of challenge, they will always have the same patterns, and the only real problem is to lure stronger enemies away and pick them out individually. Larger enemies also fire their long-range weapons when you're right in front of them, meaning that their shots will be completely wasted. The net result is that every part of a mission becomes boring, with you repeating the same actions over and over, always hoping that the next enemy won't have too much health, because, at least, you'll be done with the current task sooner. The lack of artificial intelligence affects allies as well. During certain missions, allied pilots will accompany you, but their only concern is to go in your opposite direction to spawn more enemies and to offer the smallest amount of support possible. In escort missions, everything reaches new heights, and to my memory, this is the first time where I forcefully moved around what I had to protect away from danger rather than attacking the actual threat. These problems ultimately make missions very boring, and some easier than they should. One mission tasks you to destroy 15 gears before your opponent does. Imagine this scenario with the AI problems described before. When I was done, my opponent had 2 kills. In the following mission, you and the same guy had to chase a red gear and destroy it. The red gear follows a predefined path, with enemies spawning when the player or the NPC reach a predetermined location. I don't know where the NPC ended up, but it surely wasn't anywhere near the red gear 99% of the time. Not to mention that the predefined path and the red gear's health bar made the mission completely uneventful and way too long for its own good. All missions share pacing and length problems, and honestly, I would have left the game long ago if it wasn't for this review. Completing a mission will usually net you a new part for your gear, along parts collected from fallen enemies. Gears can be customized in head, body, arms, legs, and shoulders. they can equip up to 3 weapons, one for each arm and one on the back. Parts will affect total gear weight, health points, movement speed, proficiency at long or short range, and so on. Weapons are divided in long range, short range, and support. Long range weapons are rifles, machine guns, spread guns. Short range weapons include swords, chainsaws, and pile drivers. Support weapons are mounted on the back only, and are usually area of effect weapons like lasers, missile launchers, flamers, mine layers, uplinks for satellite cannons, or overdrives, items that will greatly boost a gear's performance when activated. Weapon families are varied enough, and some also carry special effects, like the chainsaw ability to stun an enemy, but due to how the system is geared, there is little incentive to experiment with weapon loadouts or choose certain weapon types altogether. For example, pile drivers are very destructive, but have a large build-up time, making them easy to avoid and aim. Similarly, ranged weapons are usually half as strong as the close-range weapons, and it's impractical to go full or short-range, as the most powerful enemies will go for close-range, while smaller enemies can be dispatched at long-range without any problem. The overdrive support item is incredibly useful against bosses, as it will boost attack power, defense, and movement speed, often cutting in half the time required to get through the fight. As other support weapons appear highly ineffective against bosses and mini-bosses, anything that can boost your other weapons is very welcome. Another problem that will soon become apparent is that the shop is only useful for buying repair kits, as salvaged parts are free and superior to those sold. With the quantity of salvage on your hands, money will never be a problem, and repair kits are so inexpensive that you can load yourself with so many of them that you can force your way through missions by just healing when necessary. Controls are simple. The gear is controlled by the left analog stick. Circle, square, and triangle are assigned to 3 weapons. X is for a small dash. L uses one repair kit that fully heals your gear no matter the damage. Pressing R will make your gear move faster as long as you have boost meter. Weapons do not have ammunition, but each has an independent energy bar that will be consumed at each use and will recharge over time, a factor that is also affected by your gear. The controls work great, the gear is responsive, and you can distinctly feel the difference between heavy, slow-moving gears and nimble ones. Alternating weapon usage is a must, and recharge times are neither too long or too short. If you are playing on a Vita TV, I'd suggest to turn off touchscreen emulation, as I found the DualShock 3 is a bit oversensitive with L3 and R3. Graphics look good on the Vita screen, though they are far from being the best on the system. The gear's design is pretty cool, though it's easy to see a heavy influence from Armored Core and Front Mission. Menus are very clear, and most options are in English. Those which aren't, they are pretty easy to understand. The only language barrier is with special skills, but they are not vital. If you are interested in the story, I guess that this is another part where language skill will come into play, but personally I couldn't care less. There are no voiceovers in Damascus Gear, and whenever someone has to say something, the game will be interrupted. This is pretty annoying, especially when the operator announces that the primary target is down to 50% health, something I can already see thanks to the health bars. The background music is generic as it can get, and it's not even a loop, with a distinct pause before restarting. Sound effects are the standard stock of explosions, laser blasts and gunshots, though the sound of a blade hitting its target is pretty cool. Unfortunately, there are some bugs in the sound department. Chainsaws will mute all other sound effects, and sound level preferences won't be read when the game launches unless you go to the option menu and change one parameter. Then sound levels are applied correctly, but doing that every time is very annoying. Menus have two major oversights. You can hold a direction to quickly scroll through items, except when choosing colors, but in this case the scrolling speed is incredibly slow. And when reaching a menu's end, it's impossible to go to the other one by pressing the corresponding direction. I think this is menu programming 101, and it's a major fault in user-friendliness. So, to recap, skip Damascus Gear. I hope you have enjoyed this review, and you'll stick around for more. Briareos Kerensky, over and out.